Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're here high above Keefe Tech's Aquatic Center pool. Rossi and I are here with John Belger.
How you doing?
First game, first meet of the season. John and I are here holding down the fort along with Holly doing the camera work. And they are competing against Holliston Medway. It's going to be a little different today, John. They're going to do the diving first because it's a league meet and it's a late meet. So they want to get the diving over so they don't have to worry about anything holding up time for the swimmers.
Okay. I didn't realize that that's why they were doing it, but I'm kind of happy about that because I'm looking forward to getting out of here tonight.
So, exactly. Got to get your beauty sleep.
Got to get my beauty sleep.
As far as that goes, competing for the diving is Alyssa Annenberg, Maddie Staus, and Jack Brennan.
Yeah, now I understand that Jack Brennan, this is his first year diving.
It's either his first or second year, but it's his first year. He's doing some club diving.
Okay.
So club diving has given him the confidence and skill level to compete at the high school level and try newer and more competitive dives.
Yep.
So it allows him to increase his degree of difficulty.
Yep. Yeah, well, he certainly looks fit enough to be a good diver there.
He does. He's, it's probably close to 6 feet tall.
Yep.
And thin. And people are coming in. It's a slow arriving crowd, even though it's a late night. A lot of people are working on Central Time tonight, so they're running a little late. I see some alumni here in attendance, former captains, and a variety of parents here supporting the Hillers. I believe that is Principal Hannah, am I correct, to the left?
Yes, it is.
All 6 feet seven?
Yep.
Showing his support for the Hillers.
Yeah.
Now Medway Holliston has one diver. And so Hopkinton should do pretty well in this event. Catch a quick lead.
Now I did hear through the grapevine that Medway's boys swim team is very good this year.
Yes, Holliston has a very good team. And I apologize in advance. I have this cough that I can't get rid of. So if there's any home remedy they have, John, please express it to me
this
evening.
I will.
Pretty decent dives for Brennan. I think he gets sixes. John, after doing this for so many years and not knowing anything, I've learned a thing or two.
Yeah.
At least that's what I can tell people. That was Maddie Staus.
Now that one judge on the left there, she seems pretty low today.
And that was Alyssa Annenberg. And the Medway, Holliston Medway competitors staying right in line. Kind of missed that dive. I gave him 4.5s.
Four, 2.5, 5.
Not really sure how that, what the visual is for that, but. Solid dive for Maddie Stoss. Oh, she knocked that one home with a 2-7.
So in this event's the degree of difficulty is key.
If you want to maximize your point total.
Yep.
As they say in PGA golf, you drive for show and you putt for dough.
Gotcha.
And the Holliston boy is competing, but he's not doing anything else. Anything of degree of difficulty, so even though he gets decent scores, his scores don't multiply into a high level score. Arched a little, I'd give him 5.5, 6s. Solid dive. Similar dive. Very solid.
Nice dive. I'm at the stage, I just think I know when it looks good.
I'm sorry?
I'm at the stage, I know when it looks good.
It meets the eye test?
Yes.
Kind of like Tom Brady's 28 touchdowns and 2 interceptions?
Yes.
And he's not the MVP?
Yeah.
I must be missing something.
Yeah. The last 2 games have just been showcases of his talent.
Same dive as Maddie, who hit it. Oh, she's solid. Not as good. She jammed it.
6.5, 6.5, 7.5.
Well, guess I didn't see that one.
Mark.
Very solid dive for Maddie. Pretty solid dive. Very nice. Not bad. I think the Holliston boy only was able to do three dives, so he may not even win. So we might take one, two, and three of these.
Now tell me, as a diver, would they prefer having the small group as opposed to six on each?
I think they'd rather compete against the opponent if they could.
Yep.
Score 9.5, 9.7. This is final dive, 403 feet, inward 1.5 somersault height, 2.4.
Didn't get enough height on that one. And I think we'll take a short break.
Okay. Good. Hey, welcome back to the
I'll talk to you a second.
Keefe Tech pool. It's I'm forgetting about the dates. It's January 3rd. Tuesday night, and we just saw the swimming, the diving competition. I'm getting everything wrong tonight, Russ. It's John Belger, Russ Annenberg. The first event, the 200 medley relay. Hopkinton's got three teams. This is a mixed meet. So in lane two, Abby Fisher, Sam Richardson, Young Jun Kim, Robin Chu.
And they're off.
And they're off. So this is a 200 medley relay. So each swimmer will do 50 yards of, now we're just in the backstroke.
Backstroke first.
Backstroke first. Give it to us.
I believe butterfly, then breast, and then free.
I think you might be right, yeah. Okay, now that's an interesting one. Greg Remond just
breast,
came out of the pool.
Butterfly, I apologize.
Butterfly. Sam Cody's in there now, lane four. Hopkinson's in second and third here.
And just to set the stage for this competitive event, because it's a league meet, it's a boy-girl meet, so you try to mix up not only each individual team effort, but you got to get the second team because you want to gather as many points as you can per event, and it allows some mixing and matching. So Coach King and his staff have to figure out the metrics and the optics of how to determine what's the fastest for individuals per lane. Yeah. And we will be seeing that shortly as they come into the third portion, finishing up the third portion with Holliston Medway taking a comfortable lead.
And in lane four, that was Emily Way in the final. She's a fast freestyler. So she's probably not going to give it up. And here, over here in lane two, it's Robin Chu. Robin Chu touches out. Hopkinton second, third.
And the relays, unofficially, Holliston wins 1, 8 points, and Hopkinton wins 6 points. For the diving, Hopkinton swept, I presume, 13 points. So if you were to gauge it after two events, Hopkinton is 19-8, unofficial, of course.
You know, this being a very competitive meet, although it does look like there's going to be a second heat, but there is no second heat here. Okay, for the 200 free, lane 2, Zach Holbro, lane 4, Grace Cavanaugh, and lane 6, Jake Glover. I can tell you one thing, having a girl swimmer, my daughter's not really a lover of this format.
Yeah, what it does is, unfortunately, it pits the boys and the girls together. I'm not really a proponent of it either. It doesn't really make much sense, but I understand why they do it, because they don't have enough pool time for boy events and girl events.
Yep.
And the league just can't hold individual teams like they do in other sports.
Now, what you're seeing tonight is you're seeing Hopkinton girls wearing their fast suits. Lane 4, Grace Cavanaugh, is wearing her fast suit. Of course, she's in an event here with 4 boys. And the Holliston girl is not wearing a fast suit. Is this a 200 free?
8 laps of the pool.
Thank you, Ross.
And 25-yard laps. So it's not a sprint and it's not a marathon, so you're trying to gauge your conditioning, but you still need to hit those splits.
Absolutely, and Grace is holding her own right here. She's been having a pretty good year. I think she's been sick like the rest of the Hopkinton team.
And the goal here is to finish 2, 3, and 4, if at all possible, or at least 2, 3.
Yep.
So we're looking at lane 4 as a key component, lane 6, and lane 2 is competing against lane 1, going arm in arm.
Yeah, that in lane 2, that's Zach Holbro. Lane 6, Jake Glover.
Not really sure, and just a fashion comment, John. I noticed this woman for Holliston with high heels on. Not really
Absolutely.
Sure why that is appropriate.
I'm wondering if it's his mother.
But then again, Holliston doesn't listen to our age cam, so I think we're all set.
Yeah, we're all set on that.
And the Holliston boy is taking a significant lead, I believe, at the 150 mark.
Yeah. Now, I will say, going into this meet, the word was out there that Holliston had a very good boys team.
At least a couple of the boys swimmers are club swimmers.
It looks like the Holliston girl gave it up over there in lane 5. So this could be good for Hopkinton. Lane 2, Zach Holbro, if he can really keep pushing against his opponent, and it looks like he can, we might get a second, third, and fourth out of this race. Oh, come on, Zach.
And it's neck and neck. Push.
Come on, dig.
This is a key point. Push.
This is it. Dig.
Doesn't look like he's going to make it.
Happen. Oh, come on. That lady in the high heels. So it looks like... second, third.
And that's it.
Yeah.
So let's see if we chart this. We had 19 to 8, 14.
So
16, and Hopkinton gets 8 points.
Okay.
So it was a wash.
We got
second, third, and fifth.
Yep.
So we got 27 to 18. We're
okay,
still
we're
holding
up.
A 9-point lead, unofficially.
Unofficially,
of course.
Yep. Now we're into the 200 IM. Lane 2, Abby Fisher. See the fast suit. Lane 6, Emily Way. I believe she's got a fast suit on, yep. And Sam Richardson, lane 4.
And just for our many millions of viewers that watch us on a weekly basis, I advise you don't make any popcorn, because this meet's going to go with the blink of an eye.
Absolutely. There is a very biased crowd here tonight, and very loud crowd. And if you look to the end of the pool there, there's so many kids here to cheer on their teammates. This is a key race right here.
And I believe that's a directive straight from Coach King.
Yeah. I'd like to say that they wanted to do it themselves, but...
I'm sure they did, but
yes.
there was a gentle push.
Now I see over at the other side, Coach Terry and actually Maggie Miller and Caitlin, they're doing some split times there for the swimmers.
This is a tough one.
This is tough, yep. So 200 IM. 50 yards each stroke. Now, of course, Abby Fisher could make this happen.
She's in lane two?
Lane two, yep.
What's her signature stroke? Freestyle, right?
Freestyle, yep. And I think also butterfly. And then in lane four, you have Sam Richardson of the Richardson family. It's looking good for Hopkinton here overall. As we said, the go-in was Holliston Medway had a very good boys team, and they're proving it tonight. They must have, they've been winning each race. Hopkinton is keeping up with them.
Seems like they have 100 boys on the team.
Yeah.
With red caps.
Yeah. Coming down to the wire now.
And they're off. Looks like a second place for Hopkinton. If Abby Fisher could take.
Lane one
I'm
might
not
get a
sure.
kick.
Yeah.
No, he doesn't have anything left.
Well, he's
Abby's
got
it. Come on.
No, I'm not sure about that. Looks like Hopkinton's going to go two.
Four. Yeah.
I think he's got it.
I think he's got it, yeah. I didn't see it. He got Hopkinton got it second there, right?
I'm not sure.
Yeah, it was close. I was paying attention to second lane two, but lane four versus one over here.
I think we got a 2, 4, and five again.
Now here we go, 50 free coming up for
Seven
Hopkinton.
7 points to 9 points.
Ansley Worrell, lane two. Greg Ryman, lane four. Robin Chu, lane six.
I think unofficially we have a 6 point lead.
Every event counts so much tonight. As you see, I'm pointing it out once again, this is, if you look down the row, it's mostly boys in this race. There's a girl from Holliston and Ainsley Worrell, lane two. That's it for Hopkinton girl. And then there's Greg Ryman and Robin Chu.
Event.
Yep.
22.24. We need a first place finish just to gain some confidence. I think we're going to be
four,
okay.
Looks like it's going to happen. Greg Ryman.
Wow.
No, no. Look at that. Lane five. Come on. Out touch him. That's going to be close.
Yeah, Greg Ryman.
Greg Ryman, yeah. I think the Holliston swimmer knew that he got out-touched.
Do you have any connection to the actual scoring?
No, I tried to get Phil Fisher's cell, but I have a new cell and it's not picking up his number. And then Maureen sent to Beth and Patty Gorgle, and I haven't heard back from them.
And again, as we continue on with the meet, we'd like to thank all the volunteers and the parents for representing Hopkinton Hillers swim and dive team. They're conferring at the deck to figure out who won and whether there was a touch out or whether there was an issue. But just from the naked eye, I believe that Hopkinton.
Greg Ryman, yeah.
Won the event.
Okay, now the next one is 100 fly. Lane 2, Young Jung Kim. Lane 4, Alex Matsoukas. And lane 6, Rachel Zale. Oh, they're going to do another warm up here? It's a lot of warming up.
If they're going to do a warm up, let's take a few minute break and see if we can get a scoring.
Okay. We're about to get underway with the 100 fly. Lane 2, Young Jun Kim.
Styles by a half a
point. Here's the team scores. No?
Forty-four thirty-one.
Hopkinton after the diving. Okay, so we're about to get underway again. 100 fly, lane 2, Young Jung Kim. Lane 4, Alex Matsoukas. And lane 6, Rachel Zale. Look for a good race out of Rachel here. This is her race.
Again, Coach King's ideal situation is a 2-3, and they're holding their own right now. Again, the way it's supposed to run is that you have to have at least one girl in every event.
Yeah. Yeah, he's trying to get, he knows, it seems like the boy, true to form, the boys are having a pretty good day here in Holliston. So they could tend to win, but Hopkinton's picking up.
Yeah, the issue here is they're going to get a 3-4-5 here, unfortunately.
Yes.
So that's going to lower the point total to 41 to 50.
50-41.
50-41. Hopkinton still in the lead.
Yeah. So after the 100 fly, unofficially 50 Hopkinton, 41 Holliston. Okay, we're on to the 100 free. It's a very fast meet going here. Lane 2, Grace Cavanaugh. Lane 4, Sam Richardson. Lane 6, Robin Chu.
6 events left.
Yeah, I think it's a... This year, Hopkinton has a lot of boy swimmers, but not a lot of elite boy swimmers. And this is kind of showing how you can, Holliston's showing us how we have a lot of depth, but when they get the first places, they can hang in. And you know, we're talking about a sport that's in a pool, so depth is good.
Absolutely. For the next event.
Yeah, I don't know what's happening.
The swimmers are getting anxious. Let's go.
Lane 2, Grace Cavanaugh. Lane 4, Sam Richardson.
Let's go. Start your engines.
Just as you said, 50 Hopkinton, 41 Holliston, after the 100 butterfly.
I'd like to thank my fourth grade elementary school teacher for
that.
Ms. Forvis.
Yes. I feel like they're going to give us a score after each event from here on in.
Only because Coach King has given a lot of credence to this event throughout the week. He's put a lot of pressure on the team to succeed.
Yeah, put a lot of pressure, yeah. Good pressure, but a lot of pressure. So you see in lane four, it's good. It's a good sign. Hopkinton is right in there. Lane four, Sam Richardson of the Richardson dynasty. It's a good sign to see.
Is this the 100?
This is the 100, yep.
This is the last. So this is it right here.
This is the last lap right here, yep. So if Grace Kavanaugh can box out this guy from Holliston here,
he's
going
to lose.
Good sign. It's not going to happen.
Ah, he got touched out. What did we get? 2, 4, 5?
Oh, he got touched out at the end?
Yeah. 2, 4, 5?
Yep. We were at 50-41, right?
Yep, they got 9 points. We got 7.
57.
So 57-50.
57-50, yep. Okay, coming up, we have the 500 free. Lane 2, Bridget Belger.
Of the Belger claim.
Of the Belger claim. Lane 4, Abby Fisher. And lane 6, Zach Holbro.
Zach Holbro. That's a mouthful.
Absolutely.
Is it fair to assume that his given name is Zachary?
Yes, I think so.
Like one of our former presidents.
It's funny how after every event, there's like a meeting over there with the timers.
Yeah, because a lot of them are coming down to the buzzer. So
yes,
there's a lot of photo finishes. And the gang is cheering. Coach King is trying to reverse the curse from last year when we had sort of a disqualification and we lost the TVLs in a very unceremonial manner.
Yes.
If it was back in the 1700s, they would have had a duel, him and the other coach. They would have paced 20 steps back and shot each other.
That was the Ashland meet, you're talking about, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, the final meet, senior meet. Night.
Yeah, oh, that was something.
A lot of disappointing faces. Jim. $57.50.
Yep.
Twenty laps of the pool, 25 yards. People at the other end of the pool are giving a signal of how many laps they've completed or about to complete. When you hear the buzzer, that's the last two laps, and you go another 50 yards and your event for the day is over. This is definitely a marathon, John. So
yep.
If you could tell me what your dining itinerary was for New Year's Eve, I could tell you that I ate every type of food, carbs, protein.
Yep. I will tell you that I have a highly recommended place in Boston. It's Mario Batali's restaurant called Italy. It's in the Prudential Center. It's all, if you love Italian food, it's all kinds of Italian food.
Nice. Price?
Price there varies from pretty reasonable to expensive.
Depends how much wine you drink, I guess,
yes.
Right? Well, I'm always up for a good evening in Boston with Prudential or the North End or the
Absolutely.
South End or the Financial District. There's a variety of restaurants in Boston. I think the goal here again is second and third.
Yep.
But I don't even think we're going to get that.
Well, it's still a lot of time to go here.
Right, but I'm looking at first and second with the boys.
Yep.
It's kind of unfortunate that the boys team for Holliston is so good.
Yeah.
If it was girls on girls, I don't think we'd have this conversation.
I think it would be over. I find that to be very unusual. That's an unusual occurrence.
Well, for years, Hopkinton boys
yes.
had a plethora of individual boys that can compete in many different strokes and really carried the team.
Yeah, this is one of those races. I mean, it's like, when are you going to start the big kick is the key. And it's obviously not happened on lap 9. But it's got to happen at some point. You have to leave something back. But this guy from Holliston, he's pretty good. He's swimming with no... although he does look like his stroke is turned a little bit, but
I think the key point is the last boy in lane 4.
Yeah.
If he can somehow catch her in the next 5 laps.
Yep. Now, that's an interesting one. This is the 500 free, right?
Yep.
That must be a late starter on that. Oh, actually, okay, that must be Zach. Abby's in lane 6. They switched them.
I'm not sure where lane 1 and lane 6 are as far as I can't see the the indicator.
I can't see either.
Unfortunately, this event is not boding well for the Hopkinton faithful.
Nope.
Unless lane 1 is at the same pace, I'm not sure though.
I don't know, the state time for the sectional time for this is, for the girls is 5:51 and for the boys is 5:21. But we're not in any bell at this point. That must be for lane 3, huh?
It is, that's a good observation. The key is the lane 2 and lane 5. That's going to be the telltale.
That's going to be the teller.
Seems like she's slowing down, though.
Yeah, it's my daughter.
I'm not saying it from that standpoint.
I know.
It just seems the motion, that's all.
Absolutely.
I can't tell. From that standpoint,
come on.
It just seems.
Every part of your body needs to be kicking at this point.
Did she win?
What?
Did Abby Fisher win?
No, I guess she came in second. I don't know. Maybe she did. No.
I don't know. I can't really. I'm not sure who won that.
I don't know who won that either. I thought that lane 3. Oh, he must have been doing his warm down. Lane three. I didn't think they let that happen.
Yeah, that was strange.
Lane three won that race.
Yeah. Unless
but
I was
he wasn't at the, he wasn't, I think that's kind of dirty, to be honest. Dirty is not the right word, but.
Not, at least not the proper decorum.
Yeah, and he's out of the pool.
I don't really understand that. So he was doing a wind down when everybody else was competing?
Yeah, I think he threw people off.
Threw me off?
Yeah.
So.
I wonder if there'll be a, if there's any requirements under that.
That's strange. I've never seen that.
Yeah, I've never either. I know he was
half
way
a century of announcing.
I know he was way ahead, but that doesn't really seem right.
What do we got next, John?
Okay, we got the 200 free relay. Lane two, Jake Glover, Rachel Zale, Alex Matsoukas, Emily Way. Lane six, Tiana McCann, Mary Lauren Burke, Colin Thine, Andrew DeLeva. And lane four, Grace Cavanaugh, Ainsley Worrell, Brad Canty, and Sam Richardson. They say 62-61.
It's what they call a nail biter.
After the 500, it's 62-61 Hopkinton.
Like they say, this is not your father's Oldsmobile. Gotta get some good times for these Hopkinton swimmers with their fast suits on.
Yeah.
Is this the 200 relay?
This is the 200 free relay. Yep.
50 yards per competitor.
Yep. Once again, Holliston. Oh, it looks like Hopkinton here, lane two. That's Jake Glover touching first. Down in lane four, that was Grace. Now Ainsley is
in that the Rachel
pool.
Zale, too? Lane two?
Lane two, Rachel Zale, yep. She's hanging right with the guy from Holliston. In the pool for Hopkinton, lane two, Alex Matsoukas.
Go, Alex, go.
Brad Canty in lane four. Alex is in and out of that pool today.
Wow, he was.
Look at this, lane four, Brad Canty. Nice job there, Brad. All right. Final, Emily Way, lane two. Sam Richardson, so I'm looking to, but Sam is up against a very fast swimmer from Holliston.
Emily Ways, it's gonna be close.
It's gonna be close.
Three-way
Sam
close.
Sam Richardson, come on, Sam, pull it out. This is gonna be it. You got, he's getting gonna get touched. He's touched.
I think 1-3.
Yeah, I think so too.
But we'll take that.
We'll take it.
Because that's 10 points.
Yep.
So that brings it to 72 to 65.
Go away!
72-65.
Wow.
100 backstroke next.
Lane two, Young Jung Kim. Lane four, Greg Ramon. And lane six, Logan Salyards. And I'll continue to mispronounce Greg Riemann's name wrong.
Ryman.
Ryme.
One out of three is not bad.
Every time I say his name, I pronounce it a different way.
That's okay. I'm sure the teachers do the same thing. I think Coach King is having some heart palpitations as we speak.
I think so.
Coach King is
working the sidelines.
We should get him a Fitbit because that would give him how many steps he's gone through the course of a meet. 4 laps to the pool, backstroke. There is no diving. They get in the pool first, push off.
Whoa, 72-65 after the relay.
It's a key event. Who do we have on this?
We have lane 2, Young Jung Kim. Lane 4, Greg Ryman.
Ryman.
And lane 6, Logan Salyards.
Come on, Greg.
100 backstroke. 100 backstroke.
Come on, Young June. Come on, YJK. Oh, Greg Ryman. Is that Greg Ryman?
Yeah.
Wow, he had a nice turn.
Wow, put him right out in front.
Wow, he's got a nice body length lead. Turn, switch, flip.
Come on.
Come on, Ryman. Don't quit. Too legit to quit. First place is going to be won by Greg Ryman.
Which is a big win.
Huge.
Huge. It looks like there's a fight out between second and third, but I think it's going to be touched first. Oh, come on. Don't stop.
1-3-5. No, 1-4-5.
1-4-5.
1-4-5. 9 points to 9 points. It's a wash.
Wash.
I'm sorry. I apologize. 2 and 3, we pick up 2 points. So we pick up 2 points. So we got 9 points from 72. 81 points we have. 81 to 72. 70. 81 to 72 points. What do we have now, John?
Now we got the 100 breast. Sam Cody, lane 4. Alex Matsoukas, lane 2. Allison Fu, lane 6. I can't say the divers didn't do enough tonight, because they certainly did. They did a lot to make it, to put us into this position right here. You see Coach Karen Terry standing there on the side.
Very stoic.
Very stoic.
Reminds me of Bear Bryant.
Yep.
Just does a lot of surveying of the field. Or in this place, the water.
Yeah.
I don't see any green. I only see opaque. There's a lot of mingling going around. This does not bode well for the swimmers. They want to get in the pool, John.
Absolutely.
And they want to take care of business.
Yep. Sam Cody, lane 4. Alex Matsoukas, lane 2. Allison Fu, lane 6.
Fu or Chu?
It says Fu.
She just threw a little haymaker into that one. And they're off. 4 laps of the pool with breaststroke. This is going to be a key race. You'll see Coach King go up and down the 25 yards at least a half a dozen times.
I don't know. It looks like lane 5 is pulling away.
That's okay.
Yep.
As long as we maintain.
Yes. We're halfway there.
We'll take a 2-3.
Alex Matsoukas, it's all on him.
If we can get a 2-3-5, That gives us 8 points to 8 points. So it's a wash.
And it looks like we're gonna. Allison Fu, lane six. Okay. They're going to give us the score in a second, but I'll tell
you
the
400
relay.
It should be 89 points right now for Hopkinton.
Lane two, Jake Glover, Abby Fisher, Bridget Belger, Emily Way. Lane four, Grace Cavanaugh, Robin Chu, Rachel Zale, Greg Ryman. Lane six, Colin Thine, Tiana McCann, Ainsley Worrell, Brad Canty.
B squared swimming.
What's that?
Is B squared swimming?
Yes, she is. Lane two.
Or does she have a middle name with B too?
R.
R, no B. No cubed?
No. All my kids have R's for their middle initials.
Kind of like the Kennedys?
Yes. We're just like the Kennedys.
Just the New York version.
New York version.
I see a lot of fast suits in attendance. A
lot of fast suits, yep.
Coach King cooked this one seriously. Fast suits are competitive suits, at least psychologically competitive.
Yep.
And profitable for the manufacturers. They are. So,
89.
What 80. Hopkinton has to do in this last event is.
Yeah, they can only wear them 10 times or something.
Right.
And there's a lot of care instructions with them, too. They have to be laid flat to dry. And
this is the last event of the evening, John?
Yep, last event of the
evening. 4x100 yards?
It's 4x100, yep.
Total of 16 laps of the pool, four for each competitor. And as expected, the boy from Holliston is taking the lead.
Jake and Grace here, second and third. Now, they only get points for first through fourth or something?
First through third.
First through third in a relay, right?
8-4-2.
8-4-2? Yep.
Well, short of lightning striking Keefe Tech, it looks like Hopkinton's going to win this event.
Yep.
And I say that with all deference to Holliston,
yes.
Medway.
Holliston, Medway, yeah.
It's just a
matter
of. I would
love to see them pull it out in first place, but.
It's going to be a tough one.
It's going to be a tough one. But I don't know. This girl, this
especially
could
with
tie
two
it up.
Especially with two boys left on in lane three.
Yeah. That's true. I wish this girl could just swim another lane. This girl in lane three, I wish she could just
another 50 yards.
Yeah. Right now in the water is Rachel Zale, lane four, Bridget Belger, lane two.
Yeah.
So what part of this race are we looking at now? Lane six?
Nah.
No, this is it.
Nah, this is it.
This is it, yep. Oh, yeah. Got it? Is it going to hold? Yeah. So in the water right now, lane four is Greg Ryman, lane two, Emily Way. And obviously, Medway has its best probably in there, lane three. The kid's moving.
And Hopkinton has unofficially won the meet, barring any disqualifications, John.
Yep.
They will remain undefeated in the league. And it looks like the only thing left after the last competitor finishes in lane one is the obligatory cheer, the shaking of the hands, and the final tally. The next meet Hopkinton will be competing against is Wayland Concord Carlisle. It'll be a tri-meet out of league, and it will be held at the Beatty Center at Concord Carlisle High School. Friday, January 6th, I believe.
Yep.
And hugs for all, as it's a very, very, very friendly sport where they definitely enjoy each other's company, the competitors, after the meet is over. And I will take your cue, John, and say that without the divers, we wouldn't have won.
Yeah. It's a good sign.
A 1-2-3 finish.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, I have to say, it was a competitive, exciting meet.
It was. And, there was a lot of cheering going on.
A lot of cheering going on.
A lot of movement by Coach King. That's a good sign.
A lot of movement. Yep. Hopkinton wins it 95-88.
And another victory for Coach King as they do the cheer. And the meet is over. We thank all that helped this evening, and we'll see you down the road. This is Ross Annenberg and John Belger signing off.